Recording also. Everybody open up page number 108. And everyone, please open your cameras once again. I'm requesting you. Very nice, Aradhya. Shall I start calling out your names, those who are not putting your cameras on? Shreya Utkarsh, Yashika, Anshika, Taranjot, Akshita. Everybody open your cameras. Okay, on page number 108, now we have two small paragraphs given, right? Can you see? One is Maupati Chien, sorry, Ma Chien, and the other one, Bonjour de Pahi.
Yes, ma'am.
What is Ma Chien?
Ma'am, my dog.
Ma'am, my dog.
My dog. And what is... What is Bonjour de Pahi?
Hello, Fred. Hello, Paris.
Hello, yes, Paris.
Hello,
ma'am. Good day from Paris.
Hello, or good day, or good morning from Paris. So somebody is in Paris, and from there, that hello is coming. Hello from Paris. Now, what you have to do, children, you have to take your copies out, and you have to note down all the verbs given in these two paragraphs. Note down all the verbs, whether it is avoir, être, or any other verb that you come across. Whether it is a regular verb or it is an irregular verb. What are irregular verbs that we have studied so far? We have studied three irregular verbs.
Ma'am, être, avoir, and...
aller.
Aller.
Rest, we have studied regular ones and just one group, that is ER group, the first group of verbs. Write down all the verbs. You have 2 minutes with you, and then you're going to share what verbs have you got from these two passages.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, like it is given, ele patit a il a u q. Ma'am, so in this a, ma'am, a is the verb. Ma'am, we have to write il with it or just a.
You have to write a and then which verb it is it. It's avoir verb, like that.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of, ma'am, in the last sentence, what is the meaning of J-O? U-E.
Okay. It's also a verb, jouer. Now, jouer means to play. Le soir, je joue avec mon chien.
Ma'am, if a verb is being repeated, we have to count it.
No, don't count them.
Okay, ma'am.
Done.
Ma'am, J will come in hour.
AI, yes, it will come in hour.
Ma'am, like the sentence is ma famille est grande. Ma'am, so A will be counted as a verb?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Of course, beta. It's a helping verb, no? Here.
Yes, ma'am. Done all.
Done all. Very good. What about others? All right. What all verbs? How many verbs could you find, Saksham? In all, tell me the number of verbs.
Ma'am, in the first paragraph, I could
find... tell me just the number in both of them.
Ma'am, seven. And ma'am, in both, seven.
All right. All together, you could find seven verbs.
Wonderful. No, ma'am. All together, I could find 14.
14?
Yes, ma'am.
You repeated all the verbs? Etra and avar?
No, ma'am. How ma'am, like... Ma'am, son and A. Ma'am, they both are ether, but I've counted them separately.
All right, okay. And if you just count ether as one verb, how many verbs now tell me? Tell me the total number.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, done.
How many verbs, Anshika?
Ma'am, six.
Very nice.
Ma'am, 10. Ma'am, 10 in total.
Saksham, I could find only 6. I don't know why. You are still repeating. Anyways, doesn't matter. Now let's come on to all the verbs, children. The first verb in the first passage is A. A-I that comes from avar, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. The second verb that we have is sapel. What does sapel mean?
To call oneself.
To call oneself. Now, if we put sa before apel, that becomes sapel, to call oneself. Suppose I want to say, now see this. See in the chat box, everybody. What is this verb? This is apeler verb. Apeler means to, what does apeler mean?
To call.
To call. What is the difference between both of them? Can anybody tell me? Did I tell you that last week? Did we talk on this?
No.
What is the difference between apel and sapel? Apeler and sapeler. Anybody can make a guess?
To call and to call oneself.
Yes, to call and to call oneself. I think I did it in your class only. Now, suppose I want to say I'm calling somebody. I call someone. So, how am I going to use it? I'm going to use it, j'appelle. Suppose I say I call Saksham. J'appelle Saksham, right? That is my sentence. Now, suppose I say je m'appelle. Je m'appelle means I call myself. So, see, now look, everybody look into the chat box. Je me. What do we say when you have to say you call yourself? Tu te. What is it? How does the table go? Je me, tu te, il se, elle se. We have done all this, children. Can you recall all this? Je m'appelle Neha. Comment tu t'appelles? This is how you ask somebody his or her name. Comment tu t'appelles? Everybody, please open your cameras. I want to see your expressions. This way, it's looking like just one-way class. Everybody, I'm waiting for you. Shriya, Utkarsh, Taranjot, Yashika, Anshika. If I have to tell my name, what will I say? Je m'appelle Neha. If I want to ask you your name, how am I going to ask? Comment tu t'appelles? Tu te, right? How do you call yourself? If suppose you say he calls himself, so what do we use? We use il s'appelle. Fine? Il s'appelle. Now, we call ourselves. What is we call ourselves? Nu, right? Je me, tu te, il se, elle se, nu. That's how it comes. Then, how do you call yourself if I have to ask in a formal way? Comment vous appelez? Or vous appelez comment? Right? Remember? Then, in the end, ils il so and slash l so. This is how it comes. Everybody open your book to page number 59, the last block. Can you see the last block made on that page?
Yes.
Il zappel. Now, what does that mean? They call themselves. They call themselves. The first table says Elsa Pell. She calls herself. Second, Jama Pell. I call myself. Third one, Ilsa Pell. He calls himself. And the last one says ILS Appel with ENT in the end. Now, children, what is it? These kind of verbs which use mata, sir, nu, vu, and sir, they are called reflexive verbs. There are a lot many verbs which work on this basis. These are called reflexive verbs which include oneself. Okay? So in this, how do they work? The sir part, suppose, let me talk about this verb. It is sir appeler. The verb is sir appeler, and what do? We don't write it this way because we have E and A coming together. What are we going to do? We will write it this way. Sapler. We remove that E and replace it by an apostrophe. Is that clear? These kind of verbs are called reflexive verbs, in which the S part, sir part, works in this way, how I have written in the chat box. Ma, ta, sa, nu, vu, sa. Je me tute. This is how we say. Je me tute, il se, el se, nu, nu, vu, vu, il se, and el se. And how does appeler work? Appeler works according to the ER ending verbs. It is working on the same pattern. Can you see on page number 59? Now look at, focus your attention on the verb appeler. How does it work? You remember the working of ER ending verbs? E, ESE, ONS, EZ, ENT. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is how it works. Now your homework is, you will find at least 3 reflexive verbs in the next class, and we are going to talk on them. Write down this homework in your books or your copies. You have to find out 3 reflexive verbs. You're going to Google and you're going to get a lot of information on it. And how they are used, how we use them in sentences, we are going to work on that. And everybody write this, the sir part, how does it work? This is also a table that has to be learned. Like I made you write the table on possessive pronouns. Ma, ma, me, ta, ta, te, isn't it? Have you written that table, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
You have to write this one as well. Write it down. Write it down, and let's move on to the next verbs in the passage, in the paragraphs.
Ma'am, this one?
Beta, the one I have written in the chat box, how these reflexive verbs work. The verb works according to its rule. If it's ER, it will work on the rules of ER. If it is IR, it will work accordingly. If it is RE, it is going to work accordingly. The working of these 3 verbs are different. So appeler is what? It is an ER ending verb. It goes according to how it should work. But since it is a reflexive verb, sir part works like this. Jama, tuta, ilsa, elsa, like that. We can't write tu sa, or we can't write jata. Ja will come with ma only. Jama, tuta, like that. Clear? Write down this table and then let's move ahead. written, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Then, what is the next verb after sapeler? What is the next verb that you have written?
Ma'am, it is avoir.
Avoir, right. It is avoir. Then next.
Ma'am, aimer. Love.
Aimer.
Yes, ma'am.
Aimer. Then after that.
Être verb.
Être verb. Very good. Everybody, have you done it or there is just one student who has done it? Why are you not replying, children?
Ma'am, yes? I have written EST verb on, ma'am, in the first line only.
Oh, okay, line. That's fine. No problem. Then the next verb?
Ma'am, av. Ma'am, A-V-E-C. Avoir verb.
A-V-C. Avec. No, beta. Avec is not a verb. Avec is with. It's a conjunction. What is okay, avec? Ma'am. Avec means with. Then after that,
ma'am, I have written
petit. Yes, what are you doing?
Ma'am, I have written petit also.
Petit is a verb, Jivyansh. What is
ma'am
wrong
short.
With you? What ma'am, is petit, Jivyansh?
Ma'am, its meaning is short.
So, short kya hota hai? Adjective nahi hota short, long.
Yes, ma'am.
Hai na? So, how can you count it in verbs? Then,
Même jour, même regular verb to play.
It's jouer. Yes. Jouer is to play. Then after that,
même m'appel.
That's again sapler verb because it's yam m'appel. Okay. Then
yes, ma'am. Je habite.
J'habite. So the verb is habiter. Habiter means to live.
Live.
Then.
And that's it.
That's it. J'habiter. So here we come to the end of all the verbs, all the six verbs that we have found. Habit. So this. That's all. So children, all of you found these six verbs. Now what you have to do is you have to translate these passages in your copies. Start writing, write down the English translation of these passages because there are a few words that are new. Your vocabulary is going to get enhanced if you do it. And I am going to include these two passages in your finals. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Start writing, start doing the translation in your copies.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of QE? L A Patit A L A U QE long.
All right. Ile Patit means he is short. A L R A L R U Q long. That means and he has a long tail. What is a Q? Q is a tail. We did it in the beginning. It was given in the book. When we did ABC, Q for you learned Q only. Okay, it is not in this book.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of viand?
Viand is meat, mutton, meat. He likes the meat. He likes meat and biscuits.
Ma'am, done.
What about others? Still doing? Saksham, have you done beta both the paragraphs?
Ma'am, the first.
The first one. Start doing the second one also.
Ma'am, done the first one.
All right. What have you written the translation of the word niño?
Ma'am, cute.
Very good. Very nice.
You told us before.
And what is the translation of the last line? Le soir, je joue avec
moi. In the evening, I play with my dog.
Very nice. Good.
Ma'am, in French, biscuits are called biscuits only. No changes
yes.
there.
No, no.
Ma'am, what
so
are copies
are
called in French?
Cahier. Copy is called cahier. Notebooks and copies.
Ma'am, if in the exam I've written of 2 marks, ma'am, copies, I didn't know, so I wrote only copy. Ma'am, then ma'am, 1 mark will be deducted.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of views? Ma'am, views.
Views. Now, view means, see, he is talking about, which line is it in? Okay. They are dash but active. Now, he's talking about two people. Two people, whom is he talking about? Grandparents. So, what is he saying? They are old. Now, here they have used Vio in its masculine plural form. Why? Because he is talking about both grandfather and grandmother.
Ma'am, done all.
Very nice. What about others?
Ma'am, I am on third line of second paragraph.
Ma'am, the meaning of a with a accent is in.
What? The meaning of?
A with an accent.
Okay. A with an accent graph on it. Means to, in, or at. Like, I live in Paris. J'habite à Paris. Now there I will put A with an accent.
Okay, ma'am.
All right, children, here I end the class. The time is up and I have another meeting to attend. So you're going to post this work or we are going to discuss it next week. Don't post any work right now. Bye to all.